vibrations. We are seeing different colors because of the different vibrations they have.
In the light spectrum.
That's right.
And even if you have to maybe cut your budget a little on something else, fresh flowers can work wonders. When I go to the store, I think, well, you know, do I want to spend it? You know what? I'd rather have a meatless meal or two, save $5 or $10 here or there, and buy myself a fresh bunch of flowers, because it just lifts your mood and the mood of everyone who walks into your home, right?
It does. And in feng shui, fresh flowers are known to bring romance. So if you're just saying, oh my God, this dating thing is really getting to me, I can't seem to meet anybody, fill your apartment, get yourself some wonderful fresh flowers and add some nice apricots and red, maybe peach to your bedroom, and you'll be glowing before you know it.
Really? The color peach or the color apricot?
That's right. Those very, very warm, romantic colors bring love.
Hmm. Well, your date should be bringing you flowers in the first place, right?
I don't know. Sometimes I'm the best date I have.
Well, you know what? You got to be your own best friend in life,
that's
ultimately.
It.
So if you're buying your own flowers, enjoy
that's
them.
That's right. It makes the house smell wonderful. It makes it look beautiful. And it just brings, but as soon as they start to dry, you get rid of them.
Yeah, sometimes I stretch it out a day or two beyond when I probably should, because the leaves are getting crispy and crunchy.
Yeah, at that point, those have to go.
Because does that actually bring negative energy?
That's right. That's
really?
Right. Yeah.
What about fireplaces? You touched on this a little bit with kitchens, because traditionally the kitchen had a fire and so forth, and in modern kitchens we have stoves and ovens, but the same principle applies. What if you have a fireplace in your home? Does that make that, I mean, it can be literally the warmest place if you've got a fire going, but what effect does that have on people socially when they gather in front of a fire?
A fireplace is very, very lucky to have in your home. I just bought a little country cabin, and I keep saying, I need a fireplace. That's the next thing for next year. It brings a lot of warmth. People sit around. You just have to be careful, because it has a very powerful energy. So you want to soften it a little bit at the edges. And you do that by either putting a plant on either side of the fireplace or putting a mirror over the fireplace.
Hmm. A lot of people are putting televisions over the fireplace now.
Hmm.
What about that?
It's according to the room, where it's placed and what direction it's placed in. Hmm. So that would be on an individual basis. I would have to take a look at that.
Case by case.
Yeah.
We have a caller from Indianapolis. Sherry, you're on the air with Deborah Dunier. Hi there, Sherry.
Hi, Sherry.
Hi. I got a question. I love what you're saying, and I believe it.
Mm-hmm.
How much of it is my mental, because I want to believe it, and how much is it really the colors and the flowers and the positioning of things? Or is it both?
Yes, and I think that's very true. Look, in feng shui, we believe that you put a piece of artwork or a beautiful picture in front of where you work. So your back should be in your chair, your back should be up against the wall, and what you look at should be what you want for your life.
Uh-huh.
Now, some will say that's a lot of positive thinking.
Uh-huh.
You know, if you see it, you can make it real. I just know it works.
Uh-huh.
I have people in my life and people I've taken care of that I've done feng shui for them, and they put that up there and it changes everything. So some of it is a positive thinking, but that can never hurt. When you take a placebo, it sometimes works, which shows that we have the ability to self-heal, and we have the ability to actually co-create our lives and really get the things in our lives that we want to. And feng shui is one way of doing that, where you actually are working with the energies of these things and your own energy, when you were born, where you came from, what time you were born, what energy, what season was it, and what would we work best for you.
Okay.
Hmm.
Thank you. And I just joined late. Do you have a book or something, or is it?
I do have a blog with information posted there, and we could have conversations on that blog. And that is Living Home by Deborah, DEBRA, .wordpress.com.
Sherry, all thank right. you so much for your
thank
call
you.
And your
Bye-bye.
Interest. Deborah, I want to pick up on something you said. You said you just bought a country cabin.
That's right.
And you're a real estate expert, a real estate professional. Is this the time to buy?
It was the time for me. I would say that I'm very intuitive, and within me, it said you really need to have this for your life to be more balanced. It's close to the water. It's close to the forest, it's close to nature, and it's nothing fancy, but I can't imagine my life without it now that I have it.
I have a little place like that myself in Pennsylvania, just a little two-bedroom stone cottage, but it's got amazing fireplaces and the forest and the river, and it really rejuvenates me when I go there.
Exactly.
Especially if you spend a lot of time in big cities and traffic and stress and everything, to just go be with nature, it does create a yin-yang in your life.
Wonderful, yeah.
Have you been able to spend any time yet at your cabin?
I was there this weekend, just for an overnight, and I can't believe how differently I feel. It's all about us getting back to nature, getting back to earth. Feng Shui is about heaven, earth, and in the middle is humanity. So heaven would be everything that we can't see, all of these vibrations that we can't see, and everything that's kind of, and earth is everything that we can see, and it's kind of us sandwiched in the middle, and it's all about our relationship with our living environment and landscape.
Do you have snow yet where your cabin is?
No, not yet. I can't wait.
It is great to watch the seasons change, and that's something that in our modern world, you can get sort of out of touch with nature, but
sure.
As soon as you go back there, that suddenly becomes a really big factor in your life. When
yes.
the snow falls and the rain falls and those first buds of spring appear, it really sort of gives you perspective on your own experience on this planet.
I felt very disconnected from all of that, and kind of feel like you can't breathe after a while if you don't get back to what's really important. And, you know, during these hard times also, it's just looking up at that beautiful, amazing full moon and saying, this belongs to everybody.
I bet you had a great, peaceful night of sleep, too.
Oh, yeah.
And that is priceless, a good night's sleep. As someone who hasn't had much of that in my life, I can certainly tell you.
Come back to the cabin.
Maybe I'll drop by. Well, Deborah, it was such a pleasure to meet you. Thank you so much,
Same
Deborah Dunier,
here.
And have a wonderful holiday season at your cabin or wherever you are.
And may wonderful energy follow you throughout the season.
I feel peaceful just having you here in the studio. Thank you so much.
You're
I'm Jody Applegate, sitting in for Mark.